lose sight of one thing, that it was all started by a mouse. Walt Disney said this about his famous cartoon character, Mickey Mouse. What do you guys know about him? Well, Walt Disney created Mickey in 1928. He got the idea after he lost the rights to his first character called Oswald the Lucky Rabbit. They share a striking resemblance. The first popular cartoon that Mickey was in was Steamboat Willie. How many of you draw or doodle? Well, do you guys consider yourself good at it? Kind of. Well, I'm sure you all think you have room to improve on your skills. So it just takes practice. If it doesn't turn out the way you want, you don't always have to start over or throw it away. You can just tweak it just a little bit, and it might turn out better than you expected. So today I am going to be showing you how to draw Mickey Mouse. It's a more simple cartoon to draw than some that I have in the past, so it works better for the time frame. And so I will be showing you some materials that you need. I have an easel. It came in an art kit I bought, so you don't need one, obviously. You can use a table or any hard surface. I usually don't use it, but it's easier for you guys to see it. And I pre-drew a bunch of the stuff so that it doesn't take quite so long, because I'm very nitpicky about what it looks like, and it just saves time. So all the circles I had to draw, I just traced. Normally I do them freehand, but just so that they look nice for this, I traced them. So last night, late, I was doing this, and this coaster was the right size that I was looking for. So I used this to trace his head. So if you're into tracing things, you can find anything around the house and it'll work. I drew his ears with a cup, the bottom of the cup, or the top, I guess. I usually use a big eraser, because in case it's a bigger area you want to erase, they are more useful. I also use smaller erasers sometimes for little tiny mistakes or something I just don't want to be there. I have drawing pencils or sketching pencils. You don't need those to draw, you can just use normal ones. I bought an art kit about a year ago off a line, and it had a bunch of this stuff in it. So I use this most of the time. There's a bunch of pencils in it like this. I also use shading stumps. They are used to blend pencil marks and things like that, so it's not so harsh, and they work good for shading, like their name. So these are for more broad areas that you're shading. And then I also have these tortillion, I think is how you say them. I found these a couple weeks ago, and I wasn't sure what they were, so I Googled them, and they work better for shading really small areas. Like, I don't know, maybe just one little corner or something, because they have a pointier tip. And these are all, like, both of these are pretty cheap. I found these at Joann Fabrics for about $3. My whole art kit I bought was maybe 20-ish. There's different sizes with different amounts of things in them, so whichever fits your needs, or you don't need one at all, is all good. And so now this is going to be Mickey's head. So I just traced this. And then going on right here, so you can kind of see the gradual changes. I always start with the bigger outside shapes, and it's easier if you just break it all down into shapes and things rather than thinking about it as a whole, big picture, because otherwise it's daunting and you maybe it discourages you from trying it. So I started with the head and then the ears, and then I started to add facial features. So now I start with the eyes, typically, because everything's kind of based around his eyes. So they're just two ovals with filled-in portions at the bottom. I took a shading stump last night, and I blended them in a little bit so you don't see the harsh lines so much. So you just rub it like this, and they kind of disappear. And that's what I'm going to do with his nose, too. So you can kind of just scribble it, and then it'll go away once you start doing this. And then the shading kind of falls where you want it to. And then his mouth is just a curved line with another little curve underneath it. So then we have his face for the most part. And then I started to do his body. And I started with his arms, because if you get the arms in the right place, then his body's easy to do after that. So it's just a couple of curved lines, and I added his tongue in this one, and then you just shave the nose in again, and that sort of thing. And then his hands are a little bit trickier, but they're just basic curved lines too. So you kind of just round it a little bit, and then add another little one off to the side a little bit, and then another one. And over here, there was his whole hand in the original picture, but for space, I just did his thumb. And then finally we have the finished product, which is this, and I added his shorts, and everything is all shaded and good. His tongue, I shaded without actually adding any pencil to it. I just took the dark end of this one and went over it. And then, yeah, so now you have Mickey. And so today I showed you how to draw Mickey Mouse and gave you some tips on how to enhance your skills maybe a little bit. So then I also have a different one that I drew in the past, but thank you for listening.